So today our agenda would be to finish off parabola from your school point of view. Okay, so it is the second of our conic section topics. We have already done circles last class, I think last to last class. Yesterday was a session on mathematical reasoning, and today we'll be completing off parabola. There is nothing much in it. Okay, it's not a very big chapter, at least from school point of view. Yes, from competitive point of view, there are many more concepts which we'll be taking up once your school exams are taken care of. Okay. So parabola, as I already mentioned that it is a part of a conic. So how is the parabola actually constructed? Let's say this is a right circular double cone. Okay, this is a right circular double cone. It looks like an hourglass or something like that. Not exactly an hourglass, but it's just two cones which have been connected. Okay, so something like this. So this is called a right circular double cone. Right circular double cone. Okay. And this is the axis of this right circular double cone. So axis is basically a line which passes through the vertex of this right circular double cone here, and it is perpendicular to the base of the cone. Okay. Now, if this right circular double cone is cut by a plane, okay, if this right circular double cone is cut by a plane in such a way that this plane is parallel to, this plane is parallel to, I'm just making a diagram here. Yeah. This plane is parallel to this line. Okay, this line. So let me just show you. This is parallel to this line. By the way, these lines, they are called the generators of the right circular double cone. Okay. Okay, so these two are called the generators of the right circular double cone. So if there is a plane which chops off this right circular double cone in such a way that it is parallel to the generators, then the cross-section area that would be obtained. So let me choose a blue color pen to show you that cross-section area. So this would be a cross-section area that you would be seeing. This cross-section area is that which is called the parabola. So we call this cross-section area as a parabola. Okay, so this is how a parabola is obtained. Okay, so parabola as a conic is obtained when a right circular double cone is cut by a plane in such a way that the plane is parallel to the generator. Okay, generator of this right circular double cone. Now many people ask me, sir, why do you call that as a generator? Because normally the generator, if it rotates about this vertex, so if there's a rotation happening like this, okay, as you can see on my camera, it is going to generate that right circular double cone. That is why it is called generator. However, for our syllabus point of view, we don't need to know about generators and all. That is beyond our scope right now. It is just to connect you to why parabola is actually called a conic. Now, circles that we did, in the case of a circle, the plane is such that it is cutting a right circular double cone in such a way that it is perpendicular to the axis. So if it is perpendicular to the axis, means this angle is a 90 degree. Let me just draw it over here. This angle is a 90 degree. Then it would leave a cross-section area of a circle. So this cross-section area would be that of a circle. Getting my point? Okay. So circle is another conic. When the plane cuts, by the way, these are called naps. Okay. It is good to know the names of these things. So these are called this cone. And this cone, they are called naps. Let me write it on this side. They are called naps of the cone or naps of the right circular double cone. Okay. So the cone on the top, the cone on the bottom, they are called naps. Okay. So when a plane cuts one of the naps in such a way that it is perpendicular to the axis of the cone, it creates a cross-section area of a circle. Now, this is to understand why parabola is called a conic. Let us try to understand what is the locus definition. What is the locus definition of a parabola? Let's try to understand. So as a 2D figure, how do you define a parabola? Okay, so please note this down, everybody. By the way, this same definition you will keep hearing from me in other conics as well. In ellipse, hyperbola, etc., you will get to hear the same definition from me. Okay. So all of you, please note this down. A parabola is a path traced by a point moving in a plane in such a way that its distance from a fixed point is equal to its distance from a fixed line. Distance from a fixed line. Okay. By the way, have you done this topic in school? NPS Rajaji Nagar, have you taken up this topic in school? Hello, am I audible? Have you done this topic in school? Okay, you have done this topic in school. So you are already aware of this locus definition. Okay, great. So let me just draw this scenario. So let us say there is a fixed point. Okay, let me call it as S. And let's say there is a fixed line. Okay, let's call this line as D. Okay. And there is a point. Let's say the point is our point P. Okay, and this is a moving point. Okay, so this point is a moving point. So this is fixed. Okay, this is fixed. They are not moving anywhere. Okay, they are fixed in the 2D space. Now this point P, which is a moving point, it moves in such a way that its distance from S is equal to its distance from D. In other words, SP is equal to PM. Okay. By the way, you should also know that SP by PM is actually called E for eccentricity. Okay. So for a parabola, the eccentricity value is 1. Okay. We'll talk about eccentricity also in some time. So this point P is moving in such a way. I'm just making some dots for me to construct the parabola. Okay. So this parabola is moving in such a way that wherever it is, its distance from S is same as its distance from P. So let me just join them with dotted structure. Okay. So this kind of a structure is basically C. Okay. This structure is that of a parabola. Now parabola is not a new figure for us because we keep seeing parabola the moment we throw something at somebody. Right? Most of you who play badminton, when you hit the shuttlecock, that cock will follow a parabolic path. Okay. When you throw a ball in the air towards somebody, that ball will take a parabolic path. Okay. Not only that, the use of a parabola is also there in case of optics. Okay. Later on, you will learn when we are doing this chapter to much more detail, is that if a ray of light comes parallel to the axis of the parabola. This is called the axis of a parabola. We'll talk about it in some time. Okay, this is called the axis of the parabola. So if there is a ray of light which comes like this, okay, it comes, let's say, something like this. Then after hitting the parabolic reflector, that ray of light will automatically pass through this point S. Okay, later on we learn that this point S is called the focus. So this particular property of a parabolic reflector is utilized in the field of medical sciences, where let's say somebody wants to treat some problem in his organ. So normally what doctors do, they'll put a parabolic mirror such that problem creating object is at the focus, and they'll pass a laser beam. Okay, and that laser beam, after hitting the parabolic reflector, will pass through that focus thereby killing that, you can say, malicious object. Okay. So it is used in the field of surgery for kidneys. If let's say somebody gets a kidney stone and all, the doctors try to kill that kidney stone by keeping that kidney stone at the focus of a parabolic reflector and then passing the laser beam. Okay. Of course, the opposite of this phenomena could be used in our headlamps of the car. Okay. So I'm sure most of you would have observed that in the car, the headlamps are parabolic in nature. Okay. We call them as parabolic projectors. So what happens is, let's say if you're driving and you want to see till far. Okay. Many a times the driver needs to see very far. Okay. So there are two beams. Most of you have already noticed, would have noticed it. So if you have sat with next to the driver, he would just do the up down of the beam. Okay. Dip on, dip off, he does, right? So dip means he makes the ray dip. Okay. So you can see something which is very close to the car. But if he switches on the you can say the bulb which is at the focus, then the ray will travel far so that he can see far in the, on the road what is going to come, right? So it also finds its application in that field as well. So optics in the field of medical sciences, parabolic reflectors or parabola has a major role to play. Okay. So what's the locus definition of a parabola? How is it a conic? And how does the structure look like? Everybody is fine with that. I will show this to you on the GeoGebra tool as well. So let me show that to you on GeoGebra tool. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just make a parabola for you. Let's say y square is equal to 4x. We will see we'll see these equations a little later on in our discussion. Okay. Now this tool can actually show you the focus. So I'll show you the focus also. So focus of this parabola. So as you can see, it has shown the focus by this alphabet A. Okay. And this tool can also show you the directrix. So directrix of this. Okay. So as you can see, directrix also is seen. Okay. Now, if I take a point on the parabola, let's say here. Okay. And let me connect it to the focus A. As you can see, it has given a name G to it. And G value is right now 3.03. Okay. Now I'm going to drop a perpendicular from B onto the directrix. Okay. And let's say I call this point as C. And let me show you BC length. BC length is I. You can see I length is also 3.03. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do G divided by I. G divided by I. Okay. Right now its value is 1. Now will this value change if I make this point B move? Let's try to figure that out. Okay. So I'm moving this point B. All of you please have your eyes glued to this value. Is it changing? Is it changing? No, right? It is still at 1. It is fixed at 1. So no matter wherever you go on this parabola, that ratio of its distance from the fixed point A to its distance from the directrix is always a 1. Okay, so that is fixed to 1. Yes or no? Okay. So this is how the parabola basically is defined as a locus. Is it fine? Any questions, any concerns with respect to the definition? Now, certain terms, let's understand certain terms which we need to understand related to parabola. These terms were not used in circles, so please be careful while listening to them, because whatever terms I'm going to introduce to you, they will be completely new to you unless until you have done this chapter in school. But the same set of terms will also be required in ellipse and hyperbola as well. Okay. So let's go and identify what terms are we going to come across in parabola. So terms used in a parabola. Let me write it in white. Terms in a parabola. Let me make a diagram and keep it so that I can use it. Normally to make a parabola, I use a technique. I make a oval shaped structure like this. Okay. And I just erase half of the structure. Not exactly, this is not exactly a parabola, but just to mimic it, I am basically using this. Okay. It looks, you know, aesthetically wise, good. Okay. Now, we already have seen that this is called the focus. Okay. So this point S, the fixed point from where the distance is calculated of every point, that point is called the focus. So this point is called the focus. Okay. This line, that is the fixed line which we were talking about in the locus definition, that fixed line is called the directrix. Okay. Directrix. Okay. Don't call it as dielectrics. There was one, candidate who came to us for an interview. So he was constantly like, I asked him to give a demo on parabola. So he made this line and he was calling it dielectric. I mean, dielectric is something that you have studied in your physics maybe. Okay. It is not dielectric. It is directrix. Okay. All right. Now the line, which is basically passing through the focus and perpendicular to the directrix, that line is called the axis of the parabola. Sorry. Let me draw it. Okay. So this line is called the axis of the parabola. Let me write it in yellow. Okay. And the point where the axis, by the way, this is a infinitely extending arm. Okay. So it keeps on going on and on. Okay. As you have already seen, we have done this in our functions chapter when we were talking about the quadratic polynomials. Even quadratic polynomial graph is that of a parabola. Okay. So the point where the axis meets the parabola, that point is called the vertex of the parabola. This is called the vertex. Okay, note it down. So focus, vertex, clear everybody? Okay. If you connect any two points on the parabola, okay, let's say I connect these two points. This is called a chord of the parabola. Okay, so this is called a chord. So chord is nothing but a line segment connecting any two points on the parabola. That is called a chord. If the chord passes through the focus, if a chord passes through the focus, something like this, then this chord will be called as the focal chord. Okay, we will call this as a focal chord. Right? A line segment which is connecting two points on the parabola and perpendicular to the, you can say perpendicular to the axis of the parabola. So let me draw a structure like that. Yeah. Okay. So a line connecting two points on the parabola and perpendicular to the axis of the parabola, that line is called the double ordinate. I'm sure you would have heard of this term, double ordinate. We call it as double ordinate because the extremities of this double ordinate will have the same magnitude of the y coordinate. Of course, they will differ in sign, but the y coordinate will be the same because it is symmetrically, the position is symmetric about the axis of the parabola. Okay. Now, the most important term that you'll keep hearing is lattice rectum. Lattice rectum is a double ordinate which passes through the focus. Okay. So this line, if you see here, this is a double ordinate which is passing through the focus. And this is given a special name called lattice rectum. Okay. Lattice rectum, this is a Latin word for side line. Lattice means side, rectum means line. So since this line is located at the side, okay, this is just a name given to it. There's nothing very hard and fast about what is the logic behind calling it a side line. All of them could be side lines, right? So they just started calling it as a side line and that name has carried on. Okay. So lattice rectum is nothing but a double ordinate, which is also a focal chord. double ordinate, which is a focal chord, which is also a focal chord. You may call it as a focal chord, which is also a double ordinate, means the same thing. Okay, so it's a focal chord come double ordinate. Is it fine? Later on, you will learn that lattice rectum is the smallest. Let me write it like this, note. Lattice rectum is the shortest or smallest focal chord. Lattice rectum is the smallest or shortest focal chord. Shortest focal chord. That means of all the focal chords that you can draw to this parabola, the length of the lattice rectum would be the shortest of all of the focal chord. Okay, lattice rectum is the shortest focal chord of the parabola. Please note this down. Very, very important. Okay. Is it fine? Any questions, any concerns? So I think the terms, I will be repeating them again. Focus, directrix. So basically in the locus definition, the fixed point that we had used in our definition, that was focus. The fixed line that we had used in the locus definition, that is the directrix. Oh, it's okay, Arya. It's okay. Yeah. And if you connect any two points on the parabola, that is called the chord. If the chord passes through the focus, that will be called as a focal chord. A chord which is perpendicular to the axis of the parabola, that is called a double ordinate. So this line segment is called the double ordinate. And if there is a double ordinate which passes through the focus, then that is called the focal, that is called the lattice rectum of the parabola. Is it fine? And we have already seen here that lattice rectum is the shortest focal chord. We will prove it little later on. Okay, we will give a proof for this later on when we are doing this chapter from your JE point of view or from your competitive exam point of view. Okay. Any questions, any concerns anybody has, please do let me know. So axis is a line which divides the parabola into symmetrical halves. Okay. Is it fine? Any questions? Is it fine? All right. Now we will be talking about standard cases of parabola. Okay, so let's take them. There are four standard cases of a parabola. We will derive their equations and we will analyze those parabola with respect to the critical points as well as critical equations. Okay, so let me go to the next slide. So we are now going to talk about standard parabola. Or parabolas. By the way, plural of parabola is parabole or parabolas. Both are fine. Okay. So there are four standard parabolas or parabole. First of all, many people ask me, sir, which type of parabola we normally call as a standard parabola? Remember, we had a standard circle. Does anybody remember when I was doing circle chapter, I told you this is called a standard form of a circle? Can you tell me on the chat box which type of a circle was called standard form of a circle? Right, whose center was at the origin? Absolutely. Yes, Satyam. Correct. So in case of a parabola, we call those parabola as standard parabola whose vertex is at origin. Okay, vertex is at origin. Is at origin and axis is along one of the coordinate axes. Okay. All right, so let me show you one of such cases. Meanwhile, let me fetch that diagram which I had already taken a screenshot. Yeah. Okay. Let's say this is my parabola. So what do I do? Let me show you the axis here. So let's say this is my axis of the parabola. okay, and this is my vertex. So what do I do here is I make my coordinate axis in such a way that x-axis is along, so this is my x-axis. X-axis is along the axis of the parabola. And y-axis is like this. Okay. Yeah. So this is my y-axis. Okay. Such that the vertex actually becomes origin. Okay. So this is the case where my parabola would be called as a standard case of a parabola. Okay. Now, in order to find the equation, we need to fix this up, because without fixing origin, without fixing the reference axes, it is very difficult to write down the equation, right? Equation is what? Equation is nothing but it's a relationship between the x and the y coordinates of the point, and x and y are nothing but directed distance from these reference axes. So we have to put our reference axes somewhere. So this is how I have chosen my reference axes. So my x-axis is along the axis of the parabola, and y-axis, as you know, it should be perpendicular to the x-axis, and the vertex is chosen as our origin point. Okay. Now, one more thing I have to assume here in order to write down the equation of the parabola. So I have assumed that this point coordinate is a comma 0, where a represents the distance of the focus from the vertex. Now, please mind you, I have written here distance. Distance means something which is always positive. So remember this and don't make mistake regarding the value of A ever while solving any question. A is always a positive quantity. Please note that. Okay. So when you refer to A means the distance of the vertex from the focus. Okay, and that distance is always a positive distance. So this is your A. Okay, so that distance is always considered to be positive. Never ever take your A as negative. Okay, everything will go wrong while solving questions. So y square is equal to 4ax. Since many of you have already done this chapter in school, you are already aware that that is the equation of this type of a parabola. In that, A is always a positive quantity. Okay. However, we are going to derive that also officially in some time. Don't worry about it. Now, if this is A, we also know that this point will become minus A comma 0. Right? Why it is so? Because see, this point, let me call it as N. N and S, right, are such points whose midpoint is V. Because as per the definition of a parabola, any point on the parabola is equidistant from the focus and the directrix. So vertex is also one of the points on the parabola. So this distance and this distance are equal. And if this is a comma 0 and this is origin, then this point had to be minus a comma 0. Yes or no? So as to say that now the directrix equation has now become x equal to minus a line. Okay, so this line, the directrix has now become x equal to minus a line. So this is your directrix equation. This is your directrix equation. Right? Now, having known the focus coordinate and having known the directrix equation, now the time has come that we use our locus definition to get the equation of the parabola. So what do? We choose a generic point. All of you here, you know how to find out the locus. I know. What do? You choose the generic point. You choose a point and call that point. The moving point is h comma k. Okay. So this is a point which is moving. And it is moving in such a way that this distance, PS, is equal to PM. Let me call this point as M. Correct? So the point P satisfies the fact that SP is equal to PM. Okay, this is the locus definition. So from locus definition of a parabola, PS or SP is equal to PM. Correct. Now, what is SP? Let us write down SP. SP would be under root of H minus A the whole square, K minus 0 the whole square. Okay. And what is PM? PM is the distance of h, k from this line, x equal to minus a line, isn't it? So x equal to minus a line, what is the distance of h, k from there? So you'll say h plus a mod by under root of 1 square, right? That will become your distance PM, yes or no? Correct? So this you can use over here and write it as modulus of h plus a. Any questions in the framing of this locus condition? Please do let me know. Any issues? Okay. Now let us try to simplify it. Let's square both the sides. So if you square both the sides, you get h minus a the whole square plus k square equal to h plus a the whole square. So on simplification, this will give you h square plus a square minus 2ah. Okay. This will give you h square plus a square plus 2ah. H square cancels off. Right? A square gets cancelled off. Correct? So what we are left with is k square is equal to 4ah. Okay? So once we have struck a relationship between h and k, we can generalize them by replacing our h with an x and k with a y. So when we do that, we end up getting something like this. Y square is equal to 4ax. Okay? So this becomes your equation of this kind of a parabola. So remember, this is one of the four standard cases. So there will be four standard cases of parabola. Okay, that means for all of these four cases, the vertex will be at origin and the axis of that parabola or those parabola will be along either the x-axis or the y-axis. So this is one such case. By the way, when we refer to it by a name, I normally call it as rightward opening parabola. What do I call it as? Rightward opening parabola. However, there is no such, you can say, term which is used in the books. That is something which I have coined for, you know, my own reference. So this is a standard rightward opening parabola. So we will see a standard leftward opening parabola, standard upward opening parabola, standard downward opening parabola also. Okay. So first note this down, everybody. And if you have any questions, do let me know. Done? Any questions, any concerns? Okay. Now for this parabola, we will also derive the length of the lattice rectum because that is something which is going to be very, very useful. And a lot of questions will be asked around the lattice rectum concept. So let me just... So this is my coordinate axis, x-axis, y-axis. So lattice rectum, as I already told you, it's a double ordinate, which is also a focal chord. Okay, it's a double ordinate, which is also a focal chord. Yeah. So as you can see here, that this green line is passing through the focus, a, 0. Let me call the extreme ends as L and R, just to resonate with lattice rectum, LR, lattice rectum. So I would request you all that for this parabola, y square is equal to 4ax, please give me the length of LR. What will be the length LR coming to be? Please find it out and give me a response on the chat box. Anybody? By the way, today again, I'm sitting in one of the classrooms of Centum Academy. Most of you would not have got a chance to visit, but let me show you. This is how normally people are seated here. Okay. Okay. So it's a closed classroom. Okay. We are located in HSR layout. And this is me. And this is the blackboard. And yahan pe class ho rahi hai. Oh, very good. Most Satyam, are you sure? Okay, check it out. Check it out once again. Okay, so it's very simple to derive. So since this line is perpendicular to the x-axis, on this line, the x-coordinate is not going to change. Okay, so L x-coordinate will also be same as the x-coordinate of the focus. Okay, so let us assume that coordinate of L is a comma k. Now we already know that whatever we get for k, we just have to change the sign of that to get the k to get the ordinate for r. Okay. So at least I know that A is the abscissa for L. So what I'm going to do is, since this point L, let me write it down here. Since L satisfies the equation y square is equal to 4ax, I can just put a comma k in this. So k square is equal to 4aa. That means k square is equal to 4a square. So k is plus minus 2a, correct? So this is going to be 2a. Achha, why not minus 2a? Why did I choose 2a here, even though I got two answers? Why not minus 2a? Because I already told you that a is positive. So as you can see, this point is located above the x-axis. So its ordinate will be positive, right, Arvind? Right, that is why 2a for this. So your r automatically becomes a comma minus 2a. Okay, now anybody can figure it out who has got the basic knowledge of distance formula, that the distance between L and r will become 4a units. Okay, so please note this down and keep this in your mind. Now many people ask me, sir, if the parabola tilts or it becomes upward opening, leftward opening, downward opening, etc., does the length of the lattice rectum change? No. The length of the lattice rectum is not going to change irrespective of how you are orienting the same parabola. So the distance between the vertex and the focus, if you do four times that, that will always be the length of the lattice rectum. So I would like you to write this down. Length of the lattice rectum. Let me write it as a note. Length of the lattice rectum is always four times the distance between the vertex and the focus. Okay, this is going to be applicable to any parabola, no matter however it is oriented. This fact that length of the lattice rectum is four times the distance between the vertex and the focus, that always persists, that always stands. Is it fine, Arvind? Any questions? Oh, no problem. Okay. So without much ado, let me call this as the first of the standard cases. Okay, without much ado, we'll go to the second standard case where our parabola is a standard case. That means its vertex is at the origin and its axis is along the one of the coordinate axes, but it is opening leftward. Okay, so let us take that as well. I will sketch some diagrams over here. Okay, just for construction, I am doing all these shortcuts because freehand drawing doesn't come out very well. That's why. Okay, but please do not think that parabola is half of an ellipse or something like that. Okay, that is not. There's no relation like that. Okay, so this is your vertex origin. This is your x-axis, y-axis, and just to show the directrix, this is your directrix. This is your directrix. Okay, directrix is also a line, so let us put arrows. And this is your, okay. Now here, as I told you, this distance is A. The distance between the vertex and the focus is A. So we don't write it as A comma 0. We write it as minus A comma 0 because we want to use the fact that A is positive. Okay. Because many people ask me, sir, why don't you call that as A comma 0? Anyways, it's a point on the x-axis. Agreed. It's a point on the x-axis. But the fact that we are consistent with the fact that A is positive. A basically represents the distance between the focus and the vertex. So that is taken to be positive quantity always. Please make no mistake about it. In whatever problems or whatever exercise questions that you are going to get, never ever by mistake also take A value as negative. Okay. Your entire problem will go for a toss. Okay. So let's not make any mistake about that going forward. Now, since this is minus A comma 0 and this is origin, then this point, let me for the time being call it as N. That becomes A comma 0. In other words, the directrix now equation will be x equal to A. Correct? Now you can derive the equation like the same way as how I derived for the first standard case. But I am not going to do that because I am already aware of a graphical transformation, which I had learned in our bridge course. What are the graphical transformation that I can use here to get this equation in a faster way? I can use the fact that this is nothing but it is a mirror image of the first standard case about the y-axis. So if you're reflecting any graph about the y-axis, what gets changed in the equation of that particular curve? The sine of x. Absolutely. So without much ado, I can say that for this case of a parabola, my equation will become y square is equal to minus 4ax. Okay. And let me also remind you here that the length of the lattice rectum is not going to change. The reason being, as I told you, you have just, you know, taken the mirror image of that about the y-axis. Dimension wise, nothing is getting affected. That means the distance between the vertex and the focus is still A. So lattice rectum will be 4 times that distance. So that will be 4A units. Okay. Of course, please note down the critical points here. Minus A comma 0 is your focus. 0, 0 is the vertex. X equal to A will be your directrix. Y equal to 0 is your axis. Okay, so all these things should be, I mean, let's make an image of it in our mind so that whenever we are retrieving this data, we can just close our eyes and think of that parabola and everything we can produce from that diagram. Okay, is it fine? Any questions? Okay, so let's go to the third case without much ado. In the third case, we will make a parabola whose vertex will be at the origin. Okay. And the axis will be along the y-axis. In short, it would be an upward opening parabola. So let me make a quick diagram. Okay. And I'll just erase this part. This is your x-axis, this is your y-axis. The vertex, as I already discussed, I will keep it as origin. And this distance is A, as I already know. So I will call this point to be 0, A, because now it is on the y-axis, right? And since this is A, 0, A, and this is origin, that means my directrix should be passing through 0, IO, sorry. My directrix should be passing through 0, minus A. Okay. So this is my blue line is my directrix line. So this point here is 0, minus A. Okay. So you can call this line to be You can call this line to be y equal to minus a line. Okay, so please note this down. Now, using the locus definition, let us try to get the equation of such kind of a parabola as well. So let's say P is our moving point, but it moves in such a way that the distance SP is same as the distance PM. Okay, so using this definition, let us try to derive the equation of this standard case as well. So everybody do it and do let me know in the chat box. What do you think is the equation for this parabola, the upward opening parabola? I'm waiting for your response. Oh, Neil has already done it before. Okay, good. Neil. Anybody else? By the way, many of you would have already started working on your school projects. I hope you know that in CBSC as well as in ISC, you have to submit projects. If you need any kind of a help or an idea from my side, okay, please stay in touch. Okay, Arvind. So in 12th also, you have to submit projects. I think it's worth 20 marks, I believe. Okay, most likely you'll work it over the holidays. Okay. Very good, Satyam. Okay, so without much ado, let's figure it out. So SP distance will be nothing but under root of h minus 0 whole square, k minus a whole square, right? Equal to PM. Now, what is PM distance? So basically, this is the line y plus a equal to 0. So PM distance will be mod of k plus a by under root of 1 square, which is actually mod of k plus a only. Correct? So use it over here, mod of k plus a. Fine. Let's square both the sides. So when you square both the sides, you'll end up getting h square k minus a the whole square equal to k plus a the whole square. Okay. So this will be h square k square plus a square minus 2ak. Okay. 2ak. So k square gone, a square gone. So what you'll end up getting is h square is equal to 4ak. Okay, so when you take this guy minus 2ak to the other side, you are going to get 4ak. Yes or no? Now generalize it. So once we have reached this stage, we can generalize it. So when you generalize it, your expression will become x square is equal to 4ay. Absolutely right. Those who answered with x square is equal to 4ay. Exactly. That is the equation of the parabola. Okay. And as I already told you this before, and I'm repeating it again, it is just that you have just, let me ask you this question. If you remember the first case of the parabola, which was your rightward opening parabola, can you tell me what do you do to that so that you get this parabola? What graphical transformation you are applying to that first case that it results into this case? Can anybody tell me that? Okay, now one answer that I'm getting from everybody is, yes, Satyam has given one of the answers which I was looking for. Yes, you are obviously rotating the graph 90 degree anti-clockwise. But what actually you're doing, you are reflecting every point on that particular curve about y equal to x line. Okay, right? So see what has happened. I'm showing you a very small, you know, version of it. This was your first parabola, right? Let's say this is our line, y equal to x. Okay. So what are you doing? You are taking this as a mirror. So think as if this is a mirror. Okay. So you are reflecting this graph, this is the white parabola, about this mirror. So see how it will look like. This part is going to look like this. By the way, this is a mirror silvered from both the sides. Okay, so this is going to look like this. This part is going to look like this. And this part is going to look like this. Okay. Right. So it became our, so from y square is equal to 4ax, it became our yellow parabola, which is x square is equal to 4ay. Okay. And if you would recall, I had also told you a graphical transformation for this scenario as well. So whenever you are reflecting any curve about y equal to x line, in the equation of the curve, you just swap the positions of x and y. That means wherever there is an x, put a y, and wherever there is a y, put an x. Okay, so exactly the same has happened with in our case here as well. So in my y square is equal to 4ax, y became x and x became y. So as a result, you got x square is equal to 4ay, right? So this further justifies that whatever transformations we learned in our bridge course, they definitely work. They have to work. They are actually tried and tested theories. Okay. Is it fine? Any questions? Okay. So I was about to say length of the lattice rectum. Length of the lattice rectum still remains 4a units. It's not going to change. Is it fine? Any questions? Any concerns? So what I want you to take away from this entire scenario is the mirror image of, not mirror image, sorry, is the image of this in your mind. Sorry, I got into that mirror image concept so deep that I was using mirror image. You just have to make an image of this in your mind so that whenever asked, you can replicate everything. So where is the focus? Where is the vertex? What is the equation of the directrix? What is the length of the lattice rectum? What is the equation of the axis, etc., should be immediately coming to your mind the moment you imagine this. Okay. So let's take the fourth case, which is our last case. So this was the upward opening parabola. Now we'll go to the downward opening parabola. So the fourth case, the fourth of the standard cases. So in the fourth case, our parabola is going to open downwards. So let me just make an image here. Yeah. Okay. So in this case also, my vertex is at origin. This is my vertex. Okay. Focus will be at a distance A here. Okay. So this point will become 0, comma, minus A. And directrix will be cutting the axis. So the directrix will be cutting the axis at this point. Let's say I call it as N, which is 0, comma, A. And hence this equation of the directrix will be y equal to a. Okay. Now without much ado, we can find out the equation of this parabola as well, because it is just the mirror image of the third case about the x-axis. So when you are taking a mirror image of any curve about the x-axis, what do we normally do? Write it out on the chat box. Fast. We change the sign of. Yes, we invert the sign of y. Exactly, Satya. So it'll become x square is equal to minus 4ay. Okay. And let me tell you, the length of the lattice rectum is still going to be 4a only. It's not going to get affected because dimensionally nothing is changing. Is it fine? Any questions, any concerns? Please immediately highlight. Okay. Now, based on this locus definition and based on whatever four cases we have taken, let us start solving few questions. Okay, so let's begin with some questions. If everything is copied, do let me know. I would like to go to the next slide for a question. Okay, let's take a question. All right, so this is a question which is based on your locus understanding of the parabola. Find the equation of the parabola whose focus is at negative 1, comma, negative 2 and directrix is the straight line x minus 2y plus 3 equal to 0. Once you are done, you can either say done or you can give me a response on the chat box. Either way, you are convenient. Neil is done. Very good. Oh, sorry. So the parabola is going to appear like this. So in this case, you will see that it becomes a case where your axis of the parabola is not along the x-axis. In fact, it is not even parallel to the coordinate axis. It is basically inclined at a certain angle. Okay, so this is your axis. Okay. Anyways, we just have to follow our locus definition of the parabola to get the answer here. Very good, Satyam. Let's say the locus of this point P creates this parabola. Okay. So we have already seen that as per the locus definition, SP distance should be equal to PM. Correct? So SP should be equal to PM. So this is a locus definition for any parabola. Okay. So what is SP distance? Under root of h plus 1 the whole square, k plus 2 the whole square, okay, equal to PM. Now, what is the distance of h comma k from this line? So, you'll say h minus 2k plus 3 mod by under root of the square of the coefficients of x and y. What the point? Yes or no? Yes or no? Okay, so let's try to simplify this to a certain extent. You can square both the sides first of all, and when you square the denominator, it actually becomes a 5. So I'm bringing the 5 to the left hand side. Okay. And I'm simplifying it, but when I simplify it, you already know my way of simplifying it. I don't write everything. I just focus on the types of terms that we will be getting. For example, we'll be getting h square, we'll be getting k square, we'll be getting hk terms, x terms, sorry, h terms, k terms, constant terms, right? So I'll be using that. So I'll be using that direct method to simplify it. So this will be 5 h square and minus h square will give you 4 h square. So you will have 5k square from here and this will be 4k square. So that will leave me with a k square. This will be giving you minus 4hk. So on this side, if it comes, it becomes plus 4hk. And you will end up getting 10h from here and 6h from here. So that will be 4h. This will be 20k. And from here, you will end up getting minus 12k. So that will give you 32k. Okay. Constants here will be 25, here it will be 9. Okay, so this will give you plus 16. Okay, so please let me know if you have got the same, or please also let me know if you think I have missed out on anything. Okay. Oh, Satyam got the same. Very well done. So here we will just generalize it. So after getting this, we will generalize it. We will replace our h with an x and k with a y. So there you go. This becomes our equation of the parabola. Now the look and the feel of this parabola equation basically tells you that the parabola that you may get may not be only having, like, you know, simple terms like x square, 4ay, y square, 4ax, etc. It could be as complicated like this. That means you could have terms like x square, y square, xy, x, y, constant also occurring in the parabola. Okay. Absolutely right, Arvind. I think your answer also matches with mine. Is it fine? Any questions, any concerns anybody has, please do let me know. Please do let me know. Okay, let's see whether there is any more questions related to them. Okay, we'll come back to these questions. They're all okay. We'll come back to these questions. So first, I would like you to do one basic question here. Find number one. Vertex, number two, focus, number three, equation of directrix, number four, equation of axis, number five, length of lattice sector. Okay, for these two cases. So I'll just give you two cases to work on. Y square is equal to, let's say, minus x. That's first case. And x square is equal to 16y. Okay. So they are both standard cases. They should not take much of your time. And when you're doing it, please give me your answer in one go. Okay. So don't give me vertex and then press enter. Maybe you can do one thing. You can answer the first one A first. As of now, I'm requesting everybody to give the answers to the A part of the question. So put 1, 2, 3, 4 and put all the, you know, answers that you feel and then press enter. Okay. So that I get all your answers in one go. Please try this out. Very simple question. I think next week we should be able to complete ellipse and hyperbola as well from your school point of view. And then we'll get back to our normal routine classes of 1 day a week class. And I think we'll only have a bit of trigonometric part to be covered, trigonometric equation, property of triangles. And yes, we will also touch upon binomial theorem, even though it is not coming for your school exams, but that's a very important concept in general. Anything else that I'm missing on? We did derivatives, we did probability. Yeah, so I don't think so. Anything else is left? Yes. Anybody with the answers to the first A part of the question? So for A, okay, Vishal, very good. Okay. What about length of lattice rectum that you forgot, I believe. Okay. Anybody else for A? Okay, Satyam. Harshita, very good. Okay, let's discuss this out. The first and the foremost thing that you need to do is, you need to ask yourself, this standard case is which of the four that we have discussed? It is the second one. So this resembles y square is equal to minus 4ax. Please do not compare this with, y square is equal to 4ax. The reason being, if you compare this with y square is equal to 4ax, your a will become negative 1 by 4, which I said is a complete no-no. Please don't write your a as negative because it is representative of the distance between the vertex and the focus. Okay. So we can compare it with this. So when you compare both of them, you realize minus 4a is minus 1. So a is 1/4. Okay. Please note, we always take A as positive, always, okay? Never ever take A as negative. Now, just close your eyes and just imagine this parabola in your mind, the leftward opening parabola, okay? And start answering these questions. So where is the vertex for such a parabola? Origin, isn't it? Where is the focus of such a parabola? Minus A comma zero. So this will be minus A comma zero, correct? What is the equation of the directrix? Again, close your eyes. Equation of the directrix is x equal to a. Correct? So you'll get x equal to 1 by 4. Right? What is the equation of the axis? Equation of the axis is your, actually the axis is your x-axis. So x-axis equation is written as y equal to 0. What is the length of the lattice rectum? Length of the lattice rectum is 4a units. 4a unit means 1 unit. Okay. So if you have got all the 5, give yourself a pat on the back. Absolutely right. Okay. Anyway, these are the questions which you can get in your school also, one marker. So let's quickly do the B part as well. Okay. B part, anybody is ready with their answers? Do let me know. Okay. Okay, Nandita. Satyam. Mm-hmm. Harshita, very good, very good, very good. Arvind, okay. Okay. Arya, where is your answer? You have been keeping quiet all this while. Rohan, Smriti, Venkat, Vihan, Tanvi. Not sure why. This is the easiest you can get. Okay, so x square with what standard case will you compare this with? Obviously, the upward opening, the third case. So if you compare this equation with this equation, x square is equal to 4ay, you automatically get 4a as 16. So a becomes 4. Yes or no? Now, close your eyes and just imagine an upward opening parabola. Okay, everything related to an upward opening parabola. Okay, so where is the vertex? 0, 0, origin. Okay, correct? Where is the focus? Focus is 0, comma A. So 0, comma 4 is the focus. What is the equation of the directrix? Y equal to minus A. Correct? What is the equation of the axis? Axis is actually your y-axis. So x equal to 0 is your equation of the axis. What is lattice rectum length? 4a. 4a will be 16 units. Done. What is the issue in this? Correct. Arya, now you are sure how to do it. Okay, Arvind. So lattice rectum is 4a. Okay. Do you want me to give you one more problem or is this fine? I mean, these are all easy stuff. That is why I'm not giving you. Okay, it's fine. Okay, great. So now we are moving on to the shifted form of the parabola. So we have already completed our standard form. So there are four standard cases of a parabola. Now we are going to move towards shifted form of parabola. By the way, shifted form is also called the generalized form, not the general form. Don't get confused. It is called the generalized form. Okay. So now, let me make one of the standard cases, the first one. Okay. So let's say this is our, okay, I already have an image. So let me just borrow it from there. So let us say let me make my coordinate axes also. This is my y axis. X axis I've already made. Yeah. Okay. So this is my y square is equal to 4ax parabola. Okay. Now, I would like you to tell me, if I shift this parabola like this, let me erase this. We don't need it. Okay, let it be there. Okay, so if I shift my parabola like this, this is my x-axis, this is my, let's say, y-axis. Okay. This is my x-axis. This is my y-axis. Okay. This is the origin. Oh, sorry. This is the origin. So vertex has now come here. Okay. But when I'm shifting it, I'm shifting it in this way that the new axis of the parabola is still parallel to the old axis. That means this is still parallel to the old axis. And now the vertex has come to alpha comma beta. Okay. The vertex has come now to alpha comma beta. Okay. This green line is the directrix line. I have shifted the directrix also along with the curve. Now tell me, what is the equation of this parabola now? Who will tell me? What is the equation of this parabola now? If you want, you can write it down on the chat box as well. Tell me. Okay. So Vishal says, okay, Vishal, are you sure? Have you swapped the positions of something? I feel so. Okay, other way around. Okay, now let me take you back to your shifting of origin concept. See, when your origin was shifted to some point, h comma k, okay, how does a equation of a curve get changed because of that? How does this equation get changed because of that? Tell me. Let's say f x comma y is a curve. How does the curve equation get changed? What do you do to, you know, get the new equation? See, you already know that your small x is capital X plus h. Your small y is capital Y plus k. Correct? Yes or no? Yes or no? So can I say the same equation will now become capital X comma y equal to 0, where in fact you're replacing your small x with capital X plus h and small y with capital. So let me write it like this, better to be, yeah. So you're replacing your small x with capital X plus h, small y to be capital Y plus k. Correct? Yes or no? This is your new equation. Correct? Yes or no? Do you remember this? This was your old equation. This is your new equation. Correct? Now you tell me, everybody, think carefully before answering it. Don't be in a rush to answer this. In our situation, where has the origin got shifted to? When you are going from this situation to this situation, how have you shifted your origin so that this curve becomes the second curve? What is, I mean, indirectly, I want to ask you, what is h and k here? No, Harshita. I knew people are going to make that mistake. No, Arnav. Right, Satyam. Your h and k is actually minus alpha and minus beta. See, all of you, please notice this once again. See, you want your curve to go up and right. Let us say, assuming that your curve is going up and right. It could go in anywhere, you know, as per the requirement of the question. If you want the curve to go up, origin should come down, no? Because the curve per se is not moving. Are you getting the point? This red curve, this red parabola, it is fixed. It is not moving. Who's moving? Origin is moving, right? So if you want the curve to appear to have gone up, origin should have actually gone down. Yes or no? Correct. And if you want the curve to appear to move right, origin should have actually gone left. Correct. So if your vertex has gone to, let's say, alpha, beta, your origin should actually, in order to, you know, achieve that, your origin should have gone in the reverse direction, that is minus alpha minus beta. So this guy is your h and this guy is your k. Getting my point? Now, the old equation was y square is equal to 4ax, right? So what will happen? As I told you, change your x with capital X plus h. So change your x with capital X plus h. And change your y with capital Y plus k. So the equation will now become something like this. Okay. Of course, there's a 4a also sitting over here. Got the point? But it's not a good practice to write something in capital alphabets. So what do? We instead use small alphabets for it. Okay. So we write a small alphabet for this. Is this fine? Any questions? Is it fine? Any questions? So yes, absolutely right. Those who said change X with X minus alpha and Y with Y minus beta. Okay. Of course, you can imagine this from your graphical transformation concepts also. So the curve is actually moving. See, actually the curve doesn't move. But when I was teaching you the graphical transformations, shifting of origin was not known to us. I did not introduce shifting of origin purposely to you. Okay. So if the curve goes right and up, you already know that x becomes x minus something, y becomes y minus something, correct? But it is actually because of the origin shifting in a reverse direction. Got the point? Okay. Now, what type of questions you will get on this? Normally, the question that is asked on this is, they will ask you for the new coordinates. They will say, what is the new coordinates of the vertex? What is the new coordinates of the focus? What is the new equation of the directrix? What is the new equation of the axis? They may also ask you the lattice rectum length. By the way, let me ask you this. Does the lattice rectum length change because of shifting? No, it is not going to change, right? But yes, coordinates, equations, they are going to change because of the shifting process. Okay. So should we do a exercise here of finding the new equations and new coordinates here? Okay, so let's say for the same situation, let us write down the following: vertex, focus, equation of directrix, equation of axis, and length of the lattice rectum. Let me write it just LR for the short form. Okay, so let's do this. So vertex, you have already seen alpha, beta. Okay, now I would request you to first figure it out on your own and then I will discuss it out. Everybody try it out. Is it done? Anybody ready with the answers? Achha, by the way, am I still audible properly or was the previous one better? Is this better or are both of sound quality is same? Any feedback? It's the same. Okay. Done? Should we discuss it now? Okay. See, as I already told you, the vertex is at alpha beta. That is obvious. Okay. But I will tell you a interesting way to write down these coordinates and equations without much hassle. Okay. See, if you want to know the vertex, right? See, vertex was originally at 0, 0, right? Okay. So write it like this. Capital X. So what do you do first here? See, this is something which I call as role change method. Okay, role change. There's a role change happening. See, your new equation is this. Correct? Okay. Now, what do we do is we normally compare it with this. Okay. That means your y becomes y minus beta. And your x becomes x minus alpha. Okay, A remains A. Okay. Now for this parabola, close your eyes and remember everything about it. Vertex was at origin, correct? So origin is something which I would request you to write like this. Okay. And instead of x, who's playing the role of capital X, you place that over here. So capital X role is being played by small x minus alpha. So replace your capital X with small x minus alpha. Similarly, capital Y role is being played by Y minus beta. So put that here and solve for your X. So when you solve for your X, you automatically get X as alpha, and you solve for your Y, you automatically get Y as beta. So alpha beta becomes your vertex. Alpha beta becomes your vertex. Simple as that. Right? So you don't have to imagine the figure while solving the question. Many people start imagining the figure. Oh, sir, it got shifted like this. So my vertex would have gone there. My focus would have gone there. My directrix would have shifted this position. All of that you do not need to know. Okay? Just follow this trick of mine. You will be able to find all the coordinates, all the equations in a hassle-free way. Okay? Next. Focus I want to find out, right? So for capital Y square is equal to 4ax, what used to be the focus? Focus used to be a comma 0. So write like this. So capital X equal to a and capital Y equal to 0. And just see who is playing the role of capital X, who is playing the role of capital Y. And just equate it to a and 0 respectively. So your X becomes a plus alpha and your Y becomes beta. So now just collect it like this, and this will be your focus coordinate. Okay, so this will be your focus coordinate. Is it fine? Any questions? So on the figure also, let me show you. Okay, this part, this focus will be a plus alpha comma beta. Is it fine? Any questions? Any questions? Okay. Now, next part is equation of the directrix. Equation of the directrix was capital X equal to minus A, isn't it? So in our case, capital X is small x minus alpha, correct? So your new equation will become X plus A minus alpha equal to 0. So this will become your directrix equation. Okay, so this directrix that you had drawn over here, the equation of this directrix would become X plus A minus alpha equal to 0. Let me write equal to properly. Is it fine? Any questions? Any concerns? All set? Okay. Fourth one was equation of the axes. So again, close your eyes and just imagine this parabola in your mind. In this case, your axis was your x-axis, whose equation was y equal to 0. So just write capital Y equal to 0. So capital Y equal to 0 means small y minus beta equal to 0. This itself becomes your equation of axis. Is it fine? Any questions? So this line is y equal to beta line. This line is y equal to beta line, or y minus beta equal to 0, one and the same thing. Is it fine? Any questions? Next, length of the lattice rectum, as you already know, length of the lattice rectum is not going to get affected because of shifting. So it is still going to be 4a units. So if you have any questions, any concerns, any discomfort, please do get it clarified right now, because once I start doing questions, it's going to be very difficult to explain the same things over and over again. Okay. One natural question can arise in your mind that, sir, will this work for all the standard cases when they are shifted? Yes. So even if you shift y square is equal to minus 4ax somewhere, but of course, please note that shifting must be done in such a way that the new axis is still parallel to the old axis. That is what I mean when I'm shifting. I cannot shift and rotate also. In that case, all of them will go for a toss. So let me write it down here. So in this form, our new axis is parallel to the old axis. Getting the point? Any questions, any concerns here? So let's start solving few questions. Can you scroll down? Yes, yes, why not? Scroll down. I mean, I cannot go further down. This is the end of the screen, actually. As you can see, I'm trying to push it up. It's not going here only. Okay, fine. I have heard you have got a circular from the school that from 3rd of January, you have to attend hybrid classes. Okay, great. So till what time will the school run during those days? Hybrid classes, no time info. Okay. So in case it runs till 3 o'clock, please do let us know. Okay. So that we can shift our timing slightly later on so that you can conveniently reach home and join the classes. Okay. Maybe we can delay it by half an hour or 45 minutes or so. Why not, Arvind? Yes, yes, definitely. We can always extend it to that. No issues. And once you receive any kind of a timing information, please keep us updated through that group. Okay. All right. So I have a question based on shifted parabola. Find number one. Let's again find those five things which I listed down earlier. Vertex, focus, equation of directrix, equation of axis, length of lattice sector. Okay, and I just take a snapshot of this because I don't have to write it out time and again. For this hyperbola, sorry, for this parabola. So let me give you a parabola here. Y plus 1 whole square is equal to 8 times x minus 2. And only press and enter once you have responded or once you have found out the answers to all the five. So I'm giving you around 2.5 minutes to do this. Okay, do it slowly. Follow the role change method that we have discussed a little while ago that is going to give you hassle-free answers to all these five questions. Okay, Arvind. Vishal, very good. One more minute I can give for the people who are trying hard so that you can wrap up your work. Harshita, okay, very good. Satyam, good. Yes. Shall we discuss it now? All right. So as I already told you, take the role change approach. So just call y plus 1, small y plus 1 as capital Y. 4a will become 8 and capital X will be your small x minus 2. That means I'm asking you to just change the roles or do a role change over here. So capital X will be X minus 2. 4A will be 8. So A will be 2. Okay. So keep this in your mind. Right? Now, close your eyes and imagine this parabola. Okay? It's a rightward opening standard case. Okay? So close your eyes. Everybody close your eyes. And just imagine that parabola which is opening rightward. Okay? And start answering this question. Where do you think is the vertex? 0, 0. But instead of 0, 0, write capital X as 0, capital Y as 0. Okay. And just change the capital S as small x minus 2 and change your capital Y as small y plus 1. Solve for small x, solve for small y, and there you go. 2 comma minus 1 becomes your vertex coordinates. So those who have got 2 comma minus 1, absolutely right. Okay, next one. Again, close your eyes back. Where used to be the focus? Where used to be the focus? Focus used to be at A comma 0, right? So instead of A comma 0, you just have to do an extra step. Put X as A and Y as 0. Okay, and now replace. Who's playing the role of what? So this guy has been... capital X role is being played by small x minus 2, A is 2 already. And this is Y plus 1. Solve for X. So this becomes 4 comma minus 1. This is your focus. Okay. So if you have got 4 comma minus 1, absolutely right. Next. Equation of the directrix. Ayo, Arvind. Yeah, equation of the directrix. Equation of the directrix for such cases used to be capital X equal to minus A. Isn't it? So who's playing the role of capital X? Small x minus 2. Minus A will become minus 2. So X equal to 0 will become your directrix. Got the point? Any questions? Okay, that happens to be your y-axis itself. Okay, so this is your directrix equation. Any questions? Now again, close your eyes back. What used to be the axis of this parabola? You will say the x-axis. X-axis means capital Y equal to 0. So in our case, it will become Y plus 1 equal to 0. You can leave it like this. You don't have to write Y equal to minus 1. This itself is an equation. Okay, so this is your axis equation. Correct? Now length of the lattice rectum. Please understand. 4a. By the way, this constant itself is your lattice rectum. So 8. Okay. So 4a, which is nothing but 8 units. This is your lattice rectum. Is this fine? Any questions, any concerns? Do let me know. Don't worry, we'll take some more practice on this. Okay. Now I can see most of you have got everything correct. That means your concept is sound. Perfect. Okay, should we go to the next one? All right, let's try this one. I want the same five things now for this parabola. Anybody with any success? Okay, Vishal, very good. Satyam, very nice. I think yours and Vishal's answer is exactly matching. Okay, Harshita. I think same is true for Harshita as well. Good. Arvind, nice. Okay, last 45 seconds for the people who are trying hard. Okay, shall we discuss now? Everybody is ready? Okay. All right, so let's start. First of all, with which standard case? So this is a shifted version of which standard case? Let me ask this question like that. That will be more connecting to you. So it is a shifted version of y square is equal to minus 4ax, right? The left-handed parabola or the left-hand opening parabola, correct? Why? Because of this minus sign sitting. Okay, so this is the case which you are going to compare it with. So when you compare, you realize that the role of capital Y is being played by small y minus 3. The role of A is being played by 1. Before that, let me write down who is playing the role of capital X. Capital X role is being played by small x plus 3. A is 1. Okay. Now, close your eyes. Everybody close your eyes and just imagine what are the critical points and critical equations for a leftward opening parabola, right? So the vertex used to be still 0, 0. So vertex used to be still 0, 0. So 0, 0 means you will put your capital X as 0 and capital Y as 0, right? In other words, your small x plus 3 will be 0 and small y minus 3 will be 0. So X is negative 3, Y is 3. So your vertex becomes minus 3 comma 3. This becomes your vertex. Correct? I hope most of you have got this. Next, again, close your eyes. Where used to be the focus? Focus for such a parabola used to be at minus a comma 0, right? So put X as minus a, Y as 0. Now your capital X is small x plus 3. Minus a means minus 1. Capital Y is small y minus 3, put it to 0, your small x becomes negative 4, y becomes 3. So minus 4 minus 3 becomes your focus. Is it fine? Any questions? Okay. Next, equation of the directrix. So again, close your eyes. For a leftward opening parabola, directrix used to be capital X equal to A. Okay, in fact, it used to be X equal to A, but right now we are writing it as capital X equal to A. Okay, so capital X is nothing but small x plus 3, A is nothing but 1. So X plus 2 equal to 0 will become your equation of the directrix. Yes or no? Okay, next. Axis. Axis is still x-axis, so you'll say y equal to 0, or you can say y minus 3 equal to 0. That itself is your equation. So that is your axis equation. Okay. Length of the lattice rectum, as I already told you, the constant that you see over here, of course, without the negative sign, that is your 4a length. Okay. So 4a in this case would be nothing but 4 units. Okay, well done. I could see many of you have got it perfectly right. Not a single mistake anywhere. Well done. Very good. Is it fine? Any questions? Don't worry. I'll give you one more opportunity. So before break, we will take, I think, one more question on a shifted case. But if you want to copy anything down, ask anything, please do so, because this is one of the basics of your understanding of parabola. Okay, good. All right. Let's repeat the same set of questions. Find the following for let me write it just like this. y minus 1. All right, let's discuss it. Everybody is done. Most of you are still doing it. I can give 45 more seconds. Oh, okay, Harshita. Take your time. Okay, Satyam. Arnav, very good. Okay. Should we discuss it? So basically, when we are going to compare this parabola, we are going to compare it with capital X square is equal to 4ay. Okay. So who's playing the role of what? Let us discuss it over here. Your capital role, capital X role is being played by X plus 2. Capital Y role is being played by Y minus 4. And your 4A is actually 1 in this case. Because if nothing is there, you can just assume that there is a 1 over here. So that means your A becomes 1 by 4. Okay. Now, close your eyes. Imagine that there is an upward opening parabola. For your upward opening parabola, the vertex is still, for this case, vertex is still 0, 0. So your X plus 2 is 0. Y minus 4 is 0. Correct? Okay, Harshita. So x is negative 2, y is 4, which means
minus 2 comma 4 is your vertex. So this becomes your vertex. Is it fine? Any questions? Second, keep your eyes closed. And now imagine, where was the focus? Where was the focus? Focus was at 0 comma A. So write 0 for here and A for this, 0 comma A. So x plus 2 is 0 and y minus 4 is A. In this case, A is 1/4. Correct? So x becomes negative 2 and y becomes 17 by 4. So negative 2 comma 17 by 4 becomes your focus. Is it fine? Is it fine? Any questions? Next, again close your eyes and ask yourself, where used to be the directrix for an upward opening parabola? So directrix for an upward opening parabola was y equal to minus a. In other words, small y minus 4 is equal to minus 1 by 4. In other words, you can write it something like this. Okay, so 4y minus 15 equal to 0, or y equal to 15 by 4 also, that is also fine. So this used to be your, this will be your directrix. Axis for this parabola is your y-axis, so capital X will be 0, which means x plus 2 is 0. That itself is your axis. Well done. Okay. And finally, the length of the lattice rectum. The length of the lattice rectum in this case is 4a units, which in this case will become 1 unit. Is it fine? Any questions? Any questions? Any concerns? Okay. Now, I would not repeat the same type of question. Rather, we will take a different version of the same type. So let me just pick up a question here. Where should I find? Yeah, this is my parabola. Yeah, let's take this one. Find the equation of the parabola whose focus is at 4, minus 3 and vertex is 4, minus 1. Now, first make a diagram out of it. From the diagram, a lot of things will become very evident. Make a diagram. Okay, very good. See, as I told you, make a diagram. Everything will become very evident from there. So it's a vertex is at 4 comma minus 1. Okay. So 4 comma minus 1, if I'm not mistaken, it will be somewhere over here. Okay. This is 4 comma minus 1. Next. Focus is 4 comma minus 3. Okay. So 4 comma minus 3 means further down here. Somewhere here. Okay. So your parabola is actually, how is it? Can somebody guess it? You'll say, sir, it is actually a shifted version of a downward opening parabola. Am I right? Yes, it's a shifted version of a downward opening parabola like this. Okay. Now, the moment you know it's a shifted version of a downward opening parabola, immediately you will make the equation to be something. Let me write it like this. Capital X square is equal to minus 4ay. Correct? Yes or no? Now, looking at the scenario, your capital X will be X minus 4. Am I right? And capital Y will be Y minus minus 1, which is nothing but Y plus 1. Correct? And A will be this distance. Remember, A is the distance between the vertex and the focus. So, this is your A. So, A in this case will be 2 units. So, now all you need to do is just fill in this. Capital X is small x minus 4 whole square. Minus 4A will be minus 8. And capital Y will be Y plus 1. Of course, it is your wish to expand it and write it. I'm leaving it up to you. In fact, I will also, expand it and write it. So, that answer becomes X square minus 8X plus 8Y plus 24 equal to 0. Is it fine? Any questions, any concerns? Okay. So, before going for a break, one more question I would like to take on this. Okay, let's take this question. This time, same thing, vertex, focus, lattice rectum, axis, directrix. But this time, the equation has been written not in a form which was, given by me earlier. So I was very kind enough to tell you, okay, this is the way from the way I wrote down the equation, it was very evident that, okay, this was the parabola which was shifted. But don't expect the examiner to be as kind as, I was when I was giving that question. He can actually, expand the entire term, mix it up like this, and then give you a question. Okay. So let's take this as well and see whether we are able to find out the vertex, focus, lattice rectum, axis, and directrix. Try this out, everybody. Okay, Achintya. Okay, Chintya, no issues. See, dear all, please understand here. Oh, you want more time? Okay, fine. I'll give you more time, no issues. See, it's more important for you to solve it rather than me telling you how to solve it. Take time, no issues. I can wait.
Okay, ready? Should we discuss it? Or anybody needs more time? So see, look at the question first of all. You would realize that it has a second degree power or degree 2 on x. Okay, so basically, if you convert it to the forms that we have already seen in the shifted form, it must give you a quadratic in x kind of a thing, right? So normally, how do I solve this question? I just separate out, you know, the variables like this, okay? And try to complete a square here. So if I complete a square here, I would actually need 16, right? So just add a 16 on both the sides of the equation so that it becomes x plus 4 the whole square. Okay, and send the other things to the other side. So x plus 4 the whole square. Take this to the other side, will become 12. Take this to the other side, will become minus 12y. Okay. Now, express this equation like this. Take a minus 12 common, y minus 1. Now, please remember, everybody, when you are writing the shifted form of a parabola, the direct coefficient of x and y should have actually been made 1. Like how you see over here. Okay. I'm saying direct. Indirectly, it will be minus 12 here in this case. Okay. But try to make the direct coefficient as 1 for both x and the y. If it requires something to be taken common, please do it. Please take it. Okay. Now, compare this with capital X square is equal to minus 4ay. And ask yourself, who is playing the role of what? So capital X role is being played by small x plus 4. Capital Y role is being played by y minus 1. And your A is nothing but 3. A is nothing but 3. Yes or no? Okay. Now, again, close your eyes. Imagine everything that you can for the downward opening parabola. So vertex used to be at 0, 0. So write it like this. So x plus 4 will be 0, y minus 1 will be 0. So negative 4 and y will be 1. So negative 4 comma 1 will be your vertex. Is it fine? Next. Focus for this kind of a parabola used to be at 0 comma minus 8. Correct? For downward opening parabola, 0 comma minus 8. So x plus 4 is 0. Y minus 1 is minus 3. So x is minus 4. Y is minus 2. Right? So focus becomes minus 4 minus 2. Is it fine? Any questions? Any questions? Any concerns? I can see people making mistakes. Okay. All right. Next is directrix. Directrix for such cases used to be, if you close your eyes and imagine, for x square is equal to minus 4ay, directrix used to be y equal to a. Correct. So y equal to a means y minus 1 is equal to a. A is 3 in this case. So y minus 4 equal to 0. This will become your directrix. Good enough? Any questions? Axis equation for the downward opening parabola used to be y axis. So capital X equal to 0, which means x plus 4 equal to 0 becomes your axis. Correct? Next. Lattice rectum length used to be 4a units, which in this case will be 4 into 3, which is 12 units. Is it fine? Any questions, any concerns? Okay. So we'll continue with more of such questions, maybe on the other side of the break. Okay. And on the other side of the break, I will also talk about the parametric form of the equation of the parabola. And we'll do some questions also based on the same. Okay. So please copy this down, and if you have any questions, please do let me know, else we will go for a break. So So right now 6:11. We can meet at 6:26. Okay. Okay, see you on the other side of the break. Now, the next part of this chapter, we are going to discuss about parametric equations. Okay, so parametric forms of the standard parabola that we have done. In fact, we can write the parametric form for, shifted form as well. So we will start our discussion with parametric forms of the standard parabola. So let me begin with the very first of that list, which was y square is equal to 4ax. Okay. Now, again, as I already told you in the previous class, parametric forms can be numerous, right? There's no sacrosanct parametric form that, okay, this is only the parametric form. Something like this is not there. Okay. It is going to be like numerous, parametric forms are going to be possible. So fixed parametric form, there's nothing like a fixed parametric form. You can write parametric forms, numerous parametric forms for the same curve. But normally there is one parametric form which everybody uses. Okay, and that actually becomes a convention also. Okay. If you would recall in your statistics, if you recall your class 10 statistics, while we were basically taking that, assumed mean method to solve the mean of a data, our teacher used to always take the assumed mean as one of the class marks, right? But is that necessary? No, it is not necessary. It is just a convention that people follow because it has got some add-on advantages. Okay. In the same way, parametric form is not a sacrosanct value. It's like you can have numerous kind of identifications. Your Aadhaar card number can act like an identification. Your PAN card number can act like an identification. Your birth certificates. So basically, parametric form is nothing but it is trying to give an identification to every x, y point lying on that curve. Okay. So one of the parametric form which is quite recommended for this kind of a parabola is this. Please note it down. Okay, so this is a suggested or recommended, let me write it on the right side. Yeah, this is a suggested or recommended parametric form where t is a parameter. Okay, and if you try to eliminate your t, you will automatically get y square is equal to 4ax. Okay, is it fine? So if you try to eliminate your t, you will automatically get y square is equal to 4ax. So as we already know, the use of parametric form is in denoting a point on that curve. So you can represent a point on that curve with minimum number of variables involved. Okay, for example, let's say if I want to choose a point on this curve, y square is equal to 4ax, I would better choose this point, or rather choose this point as at square comma 280. Okay, as you can see, only one unknown t is involved over here, right? If you choose a generic point x1, y1, unnecessarily two unknowns will be involved, and that will make your problem solving slightly more complicated. Okay, all right. So I would now request you all to suggest me, okay, take a clue from this, and somebody please suggest me the parametric form for y square is equal to minus 4ax. What is the parametric form for this? Anybody? See, yes, Satyam. As I already told you while I was discussing the standard form, that this equation, the second one, is obtained from the first one by changing your sign of x, isn't it? Your x has been replaced with a negative x. In the same way, in parametric form also you do that. Change your at square as minus at square. That's it. Others won't change.
Okay.
So this becomes your parametric form for this curve, where t is a parameter. Achha, by the way, parameter, you can write anything. I have used t. You can write t. You can use any way, any you know, name of the alphabet. It is up to you. Okay. All right. Let's now suggest a parametric form for x square is equal to 4ay. Anybody? X square is equal to 4ay. Right. Just swap the position of x and y. So x will become 280 and y will become 80 square. Okay, so this will become a parametric form. Of course, t again here is a parameter. T again here is a parameter. Is it fine? Any questions? Okay. Fourth one. X square is equal to minus 4ay. Now you'll say, sir, simple. Change the sign of y. That's it. Yes, so x is equal to 280 and y is equal to minus 80 square. Okay, where t is a parameter. Is it fine? So just keep these parametric forms into your mind, because once we start doing these concepts from your competitive level exam point of view, we'll be using these parametric forms in order to solve many questions, because the main use of parametric form is it facilitates us to choose a point in a hassle-free manner on the curve. Okay, that is the main purpose of a parametric form. Okay. All right. So, based on this, let's take a question. So, I hope everybody has noted down the parametric form for all the four standard forms. Now, a small question. Suggest a parametric form for x minus 1 whole square is minus 8y plus 1. Okay, suggest a parametric form for this. Again, I have used the word suggest because there could be several parametric forms that you may think of. Okay, so please tell one of the forms that you feel. Very good. So you can take a clue from here. Your a will become 2 in this case. So we can use this form itself. So you can say x minus 1 is 280. 280 will become 40. That means x is equal to 40 plus 1. And y will become 8 minus 80 square, which is minus 2t square. That means y can be written as minus 2t square minus 1. Isn't it? So this finally becomes your parametric form for this curve, where t is a parameter. Where t is a parameter. Is it fine? Any questions? All right. Shall we go to the next question? Okay, let me give a question from my side here.
Okay, so let's say this is our y square is equal to 4ax parabola. Okay, let's say this is your focus S and this is a focal chord. So PQ is a focal chord. Okay, point P, the parameter is T1. Okay, that means point P, point P, the coordinates are 81 square comma 281.
In other words, you're trying to say that point P has a parameter T1 and point Q is, let's say, 82 square comma 282. That means it has a parameter of T2. Okay. Prove that if PQ is the extremities of the focal chord, prove that if PQ is a focal chord, then the product of their parameters of these two points P and Q should be multiplying to give you one. Please do this, everybody. And this is one of the properties which you are going to use very, very commonly while solving many questions. So keep this in mind. Also, later on when we are doing this concept from your competitive level point of view, we'll be using this result very, very frequently. So again, I'll repeat the question. PQ is a focal chord. T1 is the parameter for the point P. Please remember, every point has a parameter for it. So parameter is like the Aadhaar card number for that point. Okay. So the Aadhaar card number or the parameter for P is T1. And the parameter for Q is T2. Okay. So prove that T1, T2 is going to be minus 1. Very simple. It is not going to take you much time. Use the fact that PSQ is collinear. That's it. That's all you need to do. And let me know with the done if you're done. Okay, done, Satyam. Very good. Anybody else? Anybody else? See, very simple. You have to use the fact that points P, S and Q are collinear. Correct? That is to say that slope of SP should be same as slope of SQ. Okay. So what is the slope of SP? Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. Can I say the same will be applicable for the other slope as well, but it's just that your T2 will come in place of T1. Correct? Yes or no? Now let us try to simplify this equation over here. You may first cancel out 2a and 2a and a and a from your numerators and denominators respectively. Something like this. Fine. Let's cross multiply. Okay, let's open the brackets. You get T1 T2 square minus T1 is equal to T1 square T2 minus T2. Correct? Now bring this term to this side and this term to the other side. So you'll end up getting T1 T2 square minus T1 square T2 is equal to T1 minus T2. Now here take T1 T2 common. So if you take T1 T2 common, this is what you're going to get. By the way, right side also you can write it as this. Okay. Now cancel these two off. So we'll end up getting T1 T2 as a minus 1. Okay, now many people ask me, sir, T1 could have been equal to T2, but please note, T1, T2 are not the same because they are parameters of two distinct points, P and Q. Okay, as I hope you can all see the figure. T1 and T2 cannot be the same. As I told you, two points cannot have the same parameters. It's like two persons having the same Aadhaar card number. Right? It's not possible, isn't it? So here, T1 and T2 cannot be equal, so they can be cancelled off. So once you're cancelled off, you are left with T1, T2 as minus 1. Please keep this in your mind and remember this result. Okay. Now, once we have achieved this, let us go back and analyze something very interesting. But before that, if you want to copy down anything, ask anything, please do so. Okay. All right. So basically, if you again draw the figure, let me draw the figure once again. So basically, what we realized from this small exercise is that if there is a focal chord, okay, if there's a focal chord, okay, where one end of the focal chord is AT1 square comma 2AT1, then the other end of the focal chord will be nothing but A by T1 square comma minus 2A by T1. Right? Because T1, T2 is minus 1. So T1, T2 minus 1 gives us T2 as negative reciprocal of T1. Correct? So ideally, if this point would have been AT2 square, comma 2AT2, and you would replace your T2 with negative 1 by T1, then this point Q coordinates would have actually become this. Okay. So in other words, the parameters at the extremities of a focal chord are negative reciprocals of each other. For example, let's say if this point was, let's say I took T1 as a 2. So if this point was 4A comma 4A, then this point would have been, now remember, A by 2 square, which is 4, minus 2A by 2. Okay, so this point would have been A by 4 comma minus A. Getting my point? Okay, so if I know the parameter at one end of the focal chord, by the virtue of the fact that T1, T2 is minus 1, I would automatically know the parameter at the other end as well. Is it fine? Any questions? Any questions? Okay. Can I go to the next slide? Okay. Now the next question that I would like us to solve, in fact, I will be showing you something very interesting. I will be proving now that lattice rectum is the shortest focal chord. I will now be proving here that latus rectum is the shortest focal cord. So all of you, please pay attention. The proof is very simple. Just have to be attentive a little bit. Okay. Let's say this is our standard form. Y square is equal to 4ax. And let us say this is our any normal focal cord. Okay. Now we have already seen that if this point is A, let's say I call it as AT square, comma 280, then this point will become A by T square, comma minus 2A by T. Correct? Yes or no? Correct? No? Everybody is convinced with this? Correct? Now, what is SP length? Now, SP length, let us say I assume that this is my directrix. Okay. We already know that SP length is same as PM length. Correct? Because it's a parabola. In a parabola, the definition of the locus definition of the parabola says SP is equal to PM. That means the distance from the focus should be same as the distance from the directrix. Okay. Now everybody please pay attention. This is AT square and this is A. So how much is your PM length? You will say A plus AT square. Am I right? Yes or no? Anybody has any doubt with respect to the length of SP? Any questions, anybody, with the length of SP? No? Okay. So write down on the chat box, what is the length of SQ? On the chat box, write down length of SQ. I've actually drawn it also for your reference so that you can take a hint from there. Anybody? Are you? Same as QN, right? Now this length is A by T square, this length is A. This is A by T square. So what is the length? A plus A by T square, no? Yes or no? Hello? Am I audible, everybody? Nobody is responding. Okay. All right. So what is this length of the focal cord? Focal cord length is SP plus SQ, which is nothing but A plus AT square and A plus A by T square. Correct? Which is nothing but 2A plus correct? Yes or no? Right? Now, everybody please pay attention. Very interesting. Do you all recall that for positive numbers, AM is greater than or equal to GM? We had done this in our sequence series topic. Now focus on the two numbers being AT square and A by T square. So let's say we apply on this, you apply AM greater than or equal to GM. Okay. So we are all convinced both are positive numbers because A is anyways positive and you have squared up T. So can I say this term by 2 will be greater than or equal to the geometric mean? Correct? In other words, AT square, this by 2 will be greater than or equal to A square under root is A. That means this fellow is greater than or equal to 2A. Right? Everybody is convinced here? Everybody is happy with this? Yes, no. Okay. So now use this over here. Apply it at this stage. So can I say this term will be greater than or equal to 2a plus this is 2a? In other words, PQ will be greater than or equal to 4a. Now, whose length was 4a? If you recall, lattice rectum length was 4a. That means any focal chord that you make, its length will be greater than or equal to 4a, which means the least value of PQ will be 4a. Yes or no? What does this convey? This conveys that lattice rectum is the shortest focal chord. Yes or no? Yes or no? Please tell me. Is it convincing enough? Any questions, any concerns here? So lattice rectum happens to be the shortest focal chord. You cannot get any focal chord shorter than the lattice rectum. Okay. So if you get a chord which is lesser than the lattice rectum, it is not a focal chord. It is a chord, it is not a focal chord. So lattice rectum is the shortest focal chord. I'm not saying just chord, focal chord. Is that fine? Okay. Any questions? Anything that you would like to copy, ask, please do so. If not, we'll go to the next question. Okay, let's take another question. Read the question carefully. If required, read it twice. The question says, prove that the semi-lattice rectum of the parabola y square is equal to 4ax. Is the harmonic mean between the segments of any focal chord of the parabola? Okay, now let me explain this to you. What does it mean actually? Anybody who has understood the meaning of the question? I mean, let me just ask you first of all. Has anybody understood the meaning of the question? No? Right, absolutely, Satyam. So this question says, okay, let's say this is your focal chord, right? So let's say P, Q, S. Okay, so what does the question say? The question says, SP, 2A and SQ. So we need to prove that these three are in harmonic progression. Prove that the semi-lattice rectum length is the harmonic mean. So this is the mean of the segments of any focal chord. So these are the two segments, SP and SQ. Okay. That is to say, let's say this is L1. This is L2. Then L1, 2A and L2 are in HP. Can you prove it? Can anybody prove this? I'm giving you some time. Once done, you can say done on the chat box. Yes, anybody? Okay. Done. Satyam is done. Anybody else? See, guys, I don't know why it is taking so much time. I've already discussed that. Okay, let's call this as, let's call P point as AT1 square, comma, or let's call it as AT square only, YT1. Let's call T1, Y2 based. One more alphabet there. And this is A by T square, comma, minus 2A by T. Correct, no? Now, we have already seen in the previous result where we were proving that the latus rectum is the shortest vocal cord, that this is A plus AT square and L2 is A plus A by T square. Okay. Now, if you want to prove that these three are in HP, that means you need to prove these three are in AP. Correct? Okay, which means that you have to prove that 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 is 2 by 2A. In other words, you have to prove that 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 is 1 by A. Correct, let's check. So let us write 1 by L1 first. So that will be this. Okay, let's write 1 by L2 also. So this will become T square A plus AT square, correct? Let's add. So if you add, the denominators are same. So numerator will get added up. So take A common from the denominator and cancel it out. What is left? 1 by A. Done. So 1 by L, 1 by A, and 1 by L2 are in AP. Sorry, 1 by 2A. Okay. Is it fine? Any questions? So these three are in HP. Fine. Okay, so for the next 20-25 minutes of our class, we'll take some more generic problems just to wind up this concept. See, we have just covered up as I told you 20% of the concept. There are many more concepts to be covered in the parabola. As I told you in the beginning of the session, we are just doing it for our school exams purpose. In fact, we have gone beyond the school as well. So after knowing so much, you should not have any issue with the school questions. But this is not the end of the chapter. You have just done 20% of the topic. So tip of the iceberg you have done. 80% is still left. Okay. All right, let's take this question. Find the equation of the parabola with latus rectum joining these two points. With latus rectum joining these two points. you know, once you're done with this. You may just say done, or you can give me a response also in the chat box. Both are fine with me. Satyam, do you think only one answer is possible? Think hard. And how come there is square on both the sides? Okay, by the way, since I've spoken about it, let me tell you, there could be a parabola like this as well. So white and yellow, sorry, it's green color, I believe. No, yellow color. Yeah. There could be two types of parabolas. Okay. All right, done. So let us discuss it. See, first of all, you know that this is your focus point. So focus point is 3, 2. Okay. And let me also tell you that this length is 4a. Okay, so as per your question, this length is 8. So 8 is 4a, so a is 2. Correct? Now remember, there are two possibilities. One is you could have your vertex at this position, b1 position, or you could have your vertex at b2 position. Okay, if you consider your vertex to be at b1 position, you have to go 2 back from here. 2 back from here means you will end up getting at 1, 2. Am I right? Any questions, any concerns? Correct? So this is a case where your parabola was y square is equal to 4ax. And this was shifted to 1, 2. So your y will get replaced with y minus 2. X will get replaced with x minus 1. So your answer will be, for the yellow one, for this one, your answer would be is it fine? Any questions, any concerns? But this is only one of the answers. Is it fine? Any questions, any concerns anybody has? Okay, if you consider your vertex to be at B2, you have to move 2 units in this direction. So that will become 5, 2. So in that case, please note that that would be a case of leftward opening parabola. So something like this, where your y would be replaced with y minus 2 and x would be replaced with x minus 5. Okay, so this is your second case. So both of these are your answers to the question, this and this. Is it fine? Any questions? Any questions, anybody? Okay, let's take the next one. Find the equation of the parabola whose axis is parallel to the y-axis and passes through these three points, and also determine its lattice rectum, length of the lattice rectum. Let's do this question. Yes, any success, anybody? See, all of you, please pay attention here. Read the question first of all. The question says you want a parabola whose axis is parallel to the y-axis. Okay. That means your parabola could be of this nature, something like this, or something like this. Correct? Now, isn't it like saying you are writing a quadratic equation here? Because quadratic equation also follows the same nature, right? Isn't it? So this is something which you can connect it to your quadratic equations. Your quadratic equations are nothing but parabolas whose axes are parallel to the y-axis. Correct? So you can say that this is a representative of a parabola. So it represents all the parabola whose axis is parallel to the y-axis. Okay. In the same way, I would also like you to note this down that such equations will represent parabola whose axis is parallel to the x-axis. Okay. Now, very good, Vishal. Very good. Now, in order to know A, B, and C, you have been given 3 points. Let's use that 3 points to get A, B, and C. So first of all, let's use 0, 4. 0, 4 means C is equal to 4. Am I right? Correct. So that constant term is 4. Okay. Next, 1, 9. So this is 9. Okay. And then 5, 4. 5, 4 will give me something like this. Let me write it in white only. Okay. Now, since your C is 4, you can say A plus B is 5. Okay. And 16A plus 4B is equal to 1. Okay. Let's multiply this with a 4. So 4A plus 4B is 20. And 16A plus 4B is 1. Okay, subtract the results. Okay, subtract the results. You'll end up getting minus 12A is 19. So A is minus 19 by 12. Okay, put it in the first one. So A is equal to, B is equal to 5 minus A. B is equal to 5 minus A. And A is minus 19 by 12. So am I right when I say it is going to be 79 by 12? B value? Correct. So your final answer would be Y is equal to minus 9 by 12 X square plus 79 by 12 X plus 4 equal to 0. In other words, 12Y minus 19x square plus 79x plus 48 is your required parabola. Well done, Vishal. Vishal got it absolutely right. Very good. Is it fine? Any questions? Any questions, any concerns related to the solution of this problem? Clear, everybody? All right. Let's take the next one. Yeah, so this question says, if the vertex and focus of a parabola are at these 2 points, then find the equation of the parabola. Then find the equation of this parabola. This should be simple because we have already done a similar question before as well. Let me put the poll on also so that if you are done, you can put your response on the poll as well. Yeah. Okay, Satyam, we'll check. Just five of you have responded so far. Almost 2 minutes going to be over. Okay, let's give you one more minute. Let's have one more minute to solve this. Okay, should we discuss it now? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, just 8 of you have given the response. Let's discuss it out. Out of the 8 that have voted, 5 of you say option C. Okay, let's check. See, making a diagram really helps in this case. So vertex is at 3, 3. So this is your vertex position. Okay. And focus is at -3, 3. So somewhere over here. So your parabola is somewhat oriented like this. Okay. So it's a clear cut case of a leftward opening parabola which has been shifted. Isn't it? So a leftward opening parabola has been shifted in this case. Correct. So now for that, we need to know what is the A value first of all. So A value here will be nothing but, please note that this distance is your A value, which is 6 in this case. So Y square is equal to -4AX. And in this, you have to replace your capital Y with Y. I'm so sorry. This is 3. Yeah. Y minus 3 and change your capital X with X minus 3. So when you do that, it becomes Y minus 3 the whole square minus 24 X minus 3. That's it. Expand it. Let's see what do we get out of this. Okay, so on simplification, this gives you y square minus 6y plus 24x minus 63 equal to 0. Is there any option which matches this? Y square minus 6y plus 24x minus 63. Minus 63 will match with option number C. Okay, absolutely right. Option number C is the right option in this case. Is this fine? Any questions, any concerns here, anybody? Okay, let's take one last question for the day and we'll be done with the parabola chapter as well. Okay, very specific question here. What is the equation of the directrix of this parabola? Very specific question. Okay, and it's a shifted form of a parabola only. We can all sense it from the equation. So let's do this and then we will wrap up the day. Poll is on. Poll is on. Okay, Satyam, we'll check. Can we wrap this up in another 30 seconds? I can see only 6 of you have responded to this so far. 30 seconds more. Please try to finish it up in 30 seconds. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Oh my God. That's a very, very mixed response which you have all given me. 2, 2, 3. That means there is an element of confusion related to shifted cases of parabola. See, the presence of an x square term clearly shows that there is a perfect square which is supposed to be made in x. Okay, so Let's make a perfect square. So for that, I need a 4 here. So add a 4 here, add a 4 here. So this will become x minus 2 the whole square minus 8y. And this will actually become an 8 equal to 0. So take it to the other side. Correct. Right. Now compare this with capital X square is equal to 4ay. So a role is being played by 2. Capital X role is being played by X minus 2. And capital Y role is being played by Y minus 1. Okay. Now for such cases, your directrix was supposed to be, this is what they're asking us, right? Okay, the question asks us for the directrix, right? So directrix for this case used to be your Y equal to minus A. Isn't it? Because it's an upward opening parabola. So y equal to minus a is your directrix. So y is small y minus 1, minus a is minus 2. In other words, y equal to minus 1 is your answer to this question. I think that matches with option number C. Okay, so most of you went for C, but most of you made mistake also, right? So with this, we close this topic as well. From your school level point of view, we'll catch up this topic once again post your exams are over. Okay. Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care. Stay safe. Good night to all of you.